I'm Brother Thaddaeus Ruwa’ichi, a member of the Capuchin province of Tanzania. I am serving presently as the Archbishop of Mwanza in the same country of Tanzania. I've been serving as a bishop for the past 18 years, and I have served in three dioceses. My first diocese was called Mbulu, my second diocese was called Dodoma, and my present diocese is the Archdiocese of Mwanza. I'm participating at the meeting of the General Definitory, of the General Minister and his council with the bishops of the Capuchin community. First of all, I'm very grateful to the General Minister and his council for giving us this opportunity to experience once again a fraternity. I personally thank God for the gift of fraternity, which is very closely bound to our call and identity as Capuchins. And even when I'm serving as a bishop, I conserve my call as a Capuchin and my attachment to the fraternity. I understand that God wants me to serve wherever the church needs me, not necessarily as a bishop, but first and foremost as a friar. I know that the order is still getting young people who want to become members of the fraternity. I pray that many more young people continue to respond to God's call to be friars, persons of simplicity, detachment, gratuitous service, and also the willingness to embrace all God's people, especially the poorest of the poor. But poverty, as we understand, has many faces, and therefore I call upon the young people of our times to be able to recognize the many faces of poverty and to be brothers to everybody who needs to encounter Christ. I encourage the young people to cherish their particular vocation to the Capuchin fraternity. You should not allow any person to tamper with that or to take that for granted. I'm saying this having experienced the Capuchin fraternity for the past slightly over 40 years. And I pray that for the remaining part of my life, that I may continue to be, above all, a friar and a servant of the church. I ask the young people to pray for me and to pray for all the bishops who enjoy very much their vocation, first of all as the Capuchins, and who would like to see many young people following their footsteps as people called to follow St. Francis as disciples of Christ. I promise you my prayers.